So Klik was sent to fetch Bilbil, and presently returned with the goat, which was very cross this morning because it had not slept well in the underground caverns. Rinkitink lost no time in getting upon the red velvet saddle which the goat constantly wore, for he feared the Nome King would try to destroy Bilbil, and knew that as long as his body touched that of the goat, the pink pearl would protect them both, whereas if Bilbil stood alone, there was no magic to save him. Bilbil glared wickedly at King Kaliko, who moved uneasily in his ivory throne. Then the Nome King whispered a moment in the ear of Klik, who nodded and left the room.
"Please make yourself at home here for a few minutes, while I attend to an errand," said the Nome King, getting up from his throne. "I shall return pretty soon, when I hope to find you peaceful."
"That's a joke you can't appreciate now, but will later." "Be peaceful? That's the idea. How funny!"
Then he waddled from the cavern, closing the door behind him.
"Well, why didn't you laugh when Kaliko laughed?"
demanded the goat when they were left alone in the cavern. "Because he means mischief of some sort," replied Rinkitink. "And we'll laugh after the danger is over, Bilbil. There's an old adage that says, 'He laughs best who laughs last,' and the only way to laugh last is to give the other fellow a chance. Where did that knife come from, I wonder?" For a long, sharp knife suddenly appeared in the air near them, twisting and turning from side to side, and darting here and there in a dangerous manner, without any support whatever. Then another knife became visible, and another, until all the space in the royal cavern seemed filled with them. Their sharp points and edges darted towards Rinkitink and Bilbil perpetually, and nothing could have saved them from being cut to pieces except the protecting power of the pink pearl. As it was, not a knife touched them, and even Bilbil gave a gruff laugh at the failure of Kaliko's clever magic.